right, Kai.
Mm.
I'm coming in.
Yeah.
Tell me what I'm looking at.
Well, this started off yesterday as a fighting swarm. Bees do that once in a while. They try to take over another hive. It's easy to take over an existing hive rather than build your own, I guess. Today it's not that bad. We still got some dead bees here, but they clean it up mainly. Yesterday we had tons and tons of dead bees laying around here. So I think the biggest part of the fighting is over today.
Any way to know who's winning?
No, sadly enough, no.
How do they know who's on their side?
I have no idea. In the end, for the beekeeper, it doesn't really matter, because it just means that if you had a weaker hive, the stronger hive will take over, and so you end up with a genetic stronger hive, I would say. I think these bees are all just in defensive mode, because this is a eduction box. It's still connected to the mother box in the mother hive in the back. So the amount of bees that live in this hive is enormous, and I think this hive is so strong it fights off any attack. I think this one though was might be a bit weaker, and I think they attacked that hive yesterday. Okay.
Now we're standing right amongst this swarm, essentially surrounded by them. But we're not in any danger, are we?
No, they can't bite. If they're aggressive, they will nibble a bit. They often go for your eyelids or your armpits, a soft flesh. But as you see, they just land on you, and they're absolutely harmless. This is why we have them, so the kids can play with it, the kids can look at them. They're just magnificent. You know, they pollinate your garden. I love them. I absolutely fell in love with my little bees.
They're incredible.
They are. Absolutely.